Welcome to Anytime Readers, a storied escape. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and click that notification bell.
A Bad Start for Santa Claus by Sarah Hayes, illustrated by Jamie Charteris.
Santa woke up late. He looked out the window. It was snowing. It was always snowing. "It's Christmas Eve today," Santa said. He jumped out of bed and touched his toes. Under his bed, he could see a toy car. "Somebody might like that," he said, and he put the car into his spare sack. He went into the bathroom to wash his face and brush his teeth. When he pulled back the shower curtain, he was surprised to find a large drum. "My elves are getting careless," Santa said. He tapped the drum with his toothbrush and dropped the drum into his sack. Then he put on his clothes, red underwear, a long white shirt, a red jacket, a hat trimmed with white fur, an enormous pair of red pants. "Now for the boots," he said. "Maybe I should get bigger boots next year." "I need a good breakfast today," said Santa. "It's my special day." He went into the kitchen and made himself a huge breakfast. "It's getting late," he said, and he ate his breakfast quickly. Someone had left a teddy bear in his cupboard. Santa put it into his sack. Then he remembered something he had forgotten. "My mittens," he cried. "Where are my mittens? I can't go without them." He felt in his jacket pockets, but his mittens weren't there. He felt in his front pockets, but they weren't there either. "Oh dear," said Santa, "I'll have to search this place, and I'm already late." He took the elevator down to the workshop. "Have you seen my mittens?" he asked the elves, who ran the elevator. "No, SC," said the elf, "but I did find something in the elevator yesterday." He held out a wind-up mouse. Santa dropped the mouse into his sack. In the workshop, the elves were busy. Santa had to shout above the noise. "I can't find my mittens," he roared. But the elves were too busy to pay attention to him, and they were too busy to see a small doll sitting by the elevator. "You look lost," said Santa, and he gently put the doll into his sack. The next place to check was the paint shop. Santa knocked on the door. The door opened a crack, and a jet of blue paint shot by him and landed on the wall. "Sorry, SC," said an elf with blue paint on his hands and face. "What can we do for you?" "I'm looking for my mittens," said Santa. "They're red." "I know that," said the elf. "They're not here," he added. "And if they were, they'd be blue by now." He handed Santa a bright blue trumpet and shut the door. "Candy factory's next," said Santa. It was his favorite place. One of the elves gave him a peppermint stick. "I'm too full to eat it now," he said. "I'll put it into my sack for safekeeping." Then he hollered above the noise, "Has anyone seen my mittens?" But no one answered. Santa was getting worried. "I might have left my mittens in the packing room," he said. "Maybe they were wrapped up by mistake." When he looked into the packing room, all he could see was a mountain of paper and ribbon and tape. "Mittens," he said, hopefully. "Red mittens?" One of the elves emerged from the mountain. "All mittens are striped this year," he said. "No plain mittens at all. Not plain blue, not plain green, not plain yellow, and not plain red," interrupted Santa. "Oh no." Then he saw a bag of chocolate coins on the floor. "That doesn't need wrapping," he said, "and it shouldn't be on the floor." The storeroom had boxes full of presents stacked up to the ceiling, all neatly labeled. Santa caught sight of something red behind one of the stacks, but it was only a yo-yo. "This doesn't have a label," he said to the elf in charge. "Oh, take it away," said the elf. "I don't know what to do with it." Santa looked at his watch. "There isn't much time left," he said. "Where could those mittens be?" Then he had an idea. He hurried down the hallway and unbolted the boiler room door. He turned on the lights and walked carefully down the steps. "No mittens in here," said Santa after searching for a few minutes. He scrambled up the steps and slipped on a shiny whistle that had laid on the top step. "What a place to leave it," he said. Now is time to feed the reindeer. After the boiler room, the stable felt very cold. Santa rubbed his hands together to warm them up. "Where in the world could my mittens be?" he said. He gave the reindeer an extra large supper. "Do you know where my mittens are?" he asked. The reindeers munched their hay and didn't answer. "Of course you don't," said Santa. A bright yellow ball laid on top of one of the hay racks. "We're very sloppy this year," grumbled Santa, and he put the ball into his sack. The only place left to look was the shed where Santa kept his sleigh. Two elves were polishing the sleigh. "Already, SC?" they asked. Not yet, said Santa. He was starting to panic. I can't find my mittens, and if I can't find my mittens, I can't drive. And if I can't drive my sleigh, there won't be any Christmas. The elves gasped. One of them jumped into the sleigh. Maybe they're behind the seat, he said. Here's something. What is that? Let me see, shouted Santa. The elf held up a painted fan. Oh, said Santa. Oh, no. He put the fan into his sack and walked slowly back to the house. The sack was very heavy now. Santa slumped down into an armchair in the hall. He felt miserable. Next year, we have to be more organized, he said. If there is a next year, he added gloomily. At that moment, a group of elves came running up to Santa in a panic. We're the counters, said one group of elves, and we're the checkers, said the other group, and we're one sack short, they all shouted together. We don't have enough presents to go around. And I can't drive the sleigh because I can't find my mittens, said Santa. Your mittens are in your back pocket, SC, said one of the counters. That's where you always put 'em. Santa stood up, he felt in his back pocket, and he found one red mitten. He felt around in his other back pocket and found a second red mitten. Santa smiled a big smile. You've solved my problem, he said, and I think I can solve yours. Is this what you're looking for? The elves were amazed. They all spoke at once. How did you... Where on earth? Where did you find them? Oh, all over the place, said Santa. In the bedroom, in the bathroom, in the kitchen, in the elevator, in the workshop, in the paint shop, in the candy factory, in the packing room, in the storing room, in the boiler room, in the stable, in the shed. And one in the halls, cried one of the elves, holding up a toy boat that he'd found under Santa's chair. And now, said Santa, I really have to leave, or I'll be late. 1 minute to go. He picked up the sack, put on his big red mittens, and went outside. The snow had stopped. It's going to be a fine night after all, said Santa, and he sped off into the darkness. Merry Christmas, shouted the elves, but Santa Claus was too far away to hear them. The end.
We hope that you enjoyed this story. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and click that notification bell to get updated with new videos. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.